Alright, so once you get your tools ready, you're going to be needing 24 10-point socket millimeter for the axle, breaker bar, vice grips, half inch and 3/8 ratchets, an 18 millimeter, 16 millimeter, 13, a 10, an 18 millimeter wrench, a chisel, and a 3-pound hammer, or sledge, whatever you want to call it. The first things you guys want to do is break loose pretty much everything. You're going to need to start with the strut mount bolt right here. That's the 18. If you bring it down over here, it's going to be the 16. I need to break these loose as well. I recommend just take them off completely because you're going to have to pop out the spindle when you get that taken off. And then at top, you're going to need the 13 millimeter. The 13 millimeter, once you get the pretty much everything off the car. And then you're going to need a 10 mil right here for the brake line. So let's start. Come on, Alex. So first take off the 10 mil for the brake line. It's a really small bolt. Alright, so if you come in closer, you'll see right here, there's a 10 mil right here, so take that off so the brake line's not in the way when you're taking everything off. Now the next thing you want to do is do the 18 mil right here. Use your half inch socket because it's pretty hard on there. And then with your vice grips, or come over here,
triple square 14 mil.
Yeah, well, I don't have one, I'm poor.
If you have it.
With your vice grips, what you want to do is grab onto the round portion of the actual end of it.
Ready?
Go. And just hold on to it because he has to do all the work. You're just holding it in place. This way we're doing this, you gotta have two people to do this, especially for the fronts. This is actually really hard to do on your own. So I highly recommend bring a buddy over, make sure he's gonna buy food or beer, whatever you guys wanna do for all this work. So once that's out, just get it out of the way. And the next thing you're gonna do, we already did it. Sorry guys, but just get the 18 mil still. This is your end link. Make sure the other side of the car is already jacked up so there's no pressure on the actual sway bar. And this will just come out through here. Like just like that. Take this off with an 18 mil socket. It slides right out. As long as the other side of the car is jacked up, this will get the alignment straight for you and it pops right out. Just set it put the nut back on. And just get it out of the way and forget it until you're back putting it back together.
The
next thing we're gonna do is the ball joints down below. They're three 16 millimeters. They're gonna be a little hard to see. Let's see. There you go. There's a 3/16 mil right there. Recording? Okay, so the next thing we're going to do is the 24 millimeter on the axle.
Okay.
We're going to need someone to get in the car and step on the brakes. However, there's another way you can cheat. Get a screwdriver.
Also, just keep spinning. I left it, I put it back in the toolbox.
get a screwdriver
and cram it right here, right into the disc brake.
And that'll lock the axle in place for you, and just yank with all your might. Now, if you can't do it, no, it's easier to pull than to push. So hold on, Alex. Ready?
Two.
One, two,
go.
Come on, don't.
There you go.
Now we gotta break loose the axle because the spindle is really close to the car on these Mark 7s. So this will give us the leverage to pull the actual strut out. So make sure you break loose this bad boy before you do anything else. Everything else is actually off the car. We just now we gotta actually push it out of here. So that's where it gets really difficult on these cars, or any actually McPherson strut setup. So once you have the bolt out a little bit, get your 3-pound sledge and just smack it a little bit. And you'll notice it goes in. This is just pushing the axle into out of the spindle and into the chassis. Don't leave it alone. Once you get it loose, you're gonna work with that later. Got a recording?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So the next thing we're gonna do, guys, is with your chisel, make sure you get like one with a really nice fat tip. You're gonna cram it outside of the strut mount. Because if you go from bottom, there's a strut mount clip down here at the bottom that aligns the strut mount. You won't be able to hit it through the bottom. You gotta hit it through the side. So get it right there. Get your 3-pound hammer again and just wail at it. And what this is gonna do is spread open the strut. And now, since that's already spread open, we're gonna have the ability to, you'll see this has play now. And then, since we took the ball joint off, you're gonna take the spindle out of the ball joint, okay? By pressing down the control arm and pulling up on the spindle, and you should be able to slide the ball joint out. That way it gives you play to make the spindle go further down. Okay, so if you come closer over here, you notice we're gonna try to take it off without the with the axle on. You can't, because the axle prevents you from taking this out. We wanted to show you this because we still have about another inch before this this strut pops out. So what we have to do is actually take the axle out, so this gives us the clearance to drop the spindle further down to get this actually strut to come out. So if you guys are trying to do this without it, you have to take the axle out. And remember, get a 24 millimeter 10 point. It's the only way you're going to get the axle bolt out, okay guys? And then when you thread it out, hammer it out a little bit and it'll pop right out. Once you get the bolt out as much as you can, get this guy in here and just hammer the spindle. And it should, the axle should pop right out. Just like that. So this is the spindle off the actual strut. With your chisel, I'm gonna show you guys where to actually put it in. Right here. And you just hammer straight up. This way it opens up the most here. If you go from down below, it won't. Here will give you the most spread on the spindle and it will allow it to pop up even faster. A good 3-4 taps and this will open up and this will just drop. You want someone hammering it right here, a couple times here on the sway bar end link. Just tap up, up, and this will just drop straight down. Should take you a couple minutes and
These are the end result. It's off.
For more
options. Well, the next thing we're gonna do is at your local auto parts store, you can rent a spring compressor. These guys right here. They run about what? $50?
They're like $50. They usually charge you for it, and it's pretty much you return them.
You get a full refund.
Yeah, you get a full refund pretty much, and it's like $50, so you get your money back in the end, unless you want to keep it.
Yeah, it's just a rental, so. They charge you so much just for collateral, just in case you break it or you lose it. I recommend don't lose it or break it. So what you're going to do is that you're going to do the first three springs and get it lined up. Get the socket and the wrench that we need. You only need to compress one side. You don't need to compress both sides. It's not necessary. No, it was a 19. That's it right there. So once we got that set up, get your ratchet. If you want to do it with an impact gun, go for it. I don't like to because it'll over torque it and it makes it harder to take off. Once you get it down pretty good, you're good. The socket might get jammed, so just leave it there. It's not really important for right now. And then, if you got yourself one of these handy Craftsman socket through, these help a lot for loosening and tightening these very particular setups.
Ratchet
and your left. You're gonna need an Allen. And you're gonna need for these, for the stock, these are 7mm Allen sockets. So to get rid of these, once your Allen's gonna tighten, your ratchet's actually gonna loosen. So, you just... it happens. Once you get it nice and loose, get your impact gun and then knock it off. I recommend turn the volume down on your TV or your monitors because it's going to get really loud. Just impact it off. And you'll notice the spring didn't shoot out or anything because we actually compressed it safely. So the next thing you're going to do is this gentleman here, for his Mark 7, we did H&R drop springs. So what you want to do is make sure you match them up, make sure they look right. On the stock suspension, they do have a bump stop. You gotta replace this one because the provided kit comes with a new bump stop. On these bump stops, you wanna make sure the tapered side is pointing down and the slightly tapered side is pointing up. Insert this one first. You will need two hands. Just slide this in. And then, right when the surface is flush, stop, leave it there. The next thing you're gonna do is your top hat, this bad boy here, you're just gonna go on the top of the spring. Now, the portion with the most amount of leaves on the spring
is going to be pointing up. The least amount is going to be pointing down. Okay. Install. All right. There's the bushing. Make sure this bushing goes in. And you'll notice there's a flat spot here on your spring. There's a flat spot here on your bushing. That's your alignment on here. Make sure it sits nice and snug in the factory location and it doesn't spin on you. Once that's in, put your top hat on, your strut cap has an alignment. There's a notch here and there's an empty notch here. That's how you line these bad boys up. What you're gonna do next is push down, have them start it off with his hand, and then you do the rest with the impact gun. Once this is set in place, once the impact gun has stopped turning, don't go any harder. Get your socket, get your Allen socket and your straight through socket. And then what you're gonna do is set your wrench to loosen and he's gonna set his wrench to tighten. And we're gonna do both to confirm that this is on snug. Go. That's on hard. And that's installing your spring to your factory strut mount. So for this portion, what you guys want to do is, if you guys want to put this in dry, by all means go for it. It's a lot harder to do it though. We recommend just use a pretty much a everyday grease. This is just universal grease. It doesn't do anything special. Just slather around the tip of the strut. This will just allow it to go in much, much easier for you guys. Do a little bit on the inside of the strut mount. This just is going to allow you to install this a lot easier. Yeah, the manufacturer doesn't do it this way. I'm not the manufacturer. I want to do this quick, easy, and properly. And this is fine. Get a little bit of grease in there. And you'll notice there's a notch here. This is your alignment notch. Same thing here. That's how that's going to go in. So top in first. And then try to get these guys to go in even. You have to wiggle and play with it a lot, okay guys? To get this guy in, make sure to have someone with you, because you definitely need two people to do this. So the next piece is that when you want to put these in, like I was saying earlier guys, two people. Get that chisel, same way that you took it off, same way you put it back on. Line it up on the outside of it, spread that thing in, line up the notch, hammer from here, all around in a circle. That way this goes in straight and it slides and drops in. Once you get that done, take the chisel off. Put your factory bolt back in place. You're not gonna bolt this down. We're just gonna get it in place. Just in case this guy wants to slide back out again, the bolt will hold it in place and not give us any issues. And you're done with that portion. The next thing is getting the axle back into here. To do that, you wanna put the spindle back in line with the ball joint and get the axle just in the area where you want it, and then we're gonna line it up by pushing and wiggling it in. Okay guys, so we got everything back on. Just remember, everything you did to take it off, do it in reverse. The axle, to get that in, make sure you put it on the ball joint first, and then you can wiggle it into place to get it in. Once you have it pushed in a couple, like say about an inch into the back, get the axle bolt, put it in, and just thread it into place. The next thing is that you're gonna put the hard brake line back in place with a 10 mil. Same process as removing the 18 mil for the strut mount. Hold it down with the vice grip and your 18. Your sway bar end link is an 18. It goes on flawlessly. There's nothing difficult about that. Once you have all that on, get a Widowmaker. One of these guys right here. Put it underneath. Push it up. And then on top, line it up. Line it up with the three holes on top, and then hand thread the bolts in, and then ratchet them into place. Once you get that, everything else goes on nice and tight. You use your torque specifications from your online manual, and you're set. Nothing super difficult. When you're gonna tighten down the axle bolt, make sure you put your screwdriver in here so this doesn't spin. And you're done. All right, guys, and that's the front. We're getting ready to do the back right now and show you guys that. Okay, guys, for the rear, you need an 18 millimeter wrench, a 13.
Is it 13 or 16? It's a 13 wrench.
13 millimeter for the rear sway, half inch drive, and you're gonna need a 13 millimeter socket, because every bolt on here is a nut and bolt. So you're gonna need to hold one and spin the other. First thing you wanna do is get the
shock.
The shock loosened. So break that one loose first. And then right after that, get the control arm bolt loose next. And then you're gonna get the sway bar end link loose next.
Can you get the way stretch up?
Now that one goes down a little bit further down, guys, so take your time. They're all fairly easy to loosen up. And just remember, we're just loosening them right now, so we can get them started. So once you have that, get your jack, if you have a second jack. And then jack it up from right here underneath the spring perch. And give it about a good single pump. And now start taking everything off. That way when you guys want to take these bolts out, they will be able to wiggle out instead of like trying to hammering them out. It's a lot safer, less chance of you stripping or breaking any of the bolts. Okay, the next thing you guys need to do is the leveler right here. This is a little rubber bracket. It's not plastic, it's rubber. Grab a flathead and pry right here and just take it out of the way. That way when the control arm goes down, you don't snap this off. Flathead. And just grab this and pry it out. And that's it. That way you don't damage it. Okay, guys? Okay, so with the bolts removed and your jack here still doing its job, lower the jack slowly and you'll notice the spring will just decompress, come all the way down, and just pull that bad boy out. Just yank it out, nothing special. Now you're gonna require to save this. Spring's done, so get that out of here. And then just remember,
to put everything back in place in the same order that you took it off. That way you don't mess up any of the alignment or anything like that on the machine, on the car.
Okay, so with the new spring, and it's an H&R spring kit, make sure you'll notice here there's a stopping point. So this is where it's going to stop on the actual new spring. So once you get it in, you're going to have the same issue at the bottom part. You notice it's a flat part. You're going to have the same thing on there. So when you insert them, make sure they get stopped with the bushing that's in there. Once you stop, you gotta go the other way. Oh. There you go.
Yeah, right there, perfect.
Once you have it there, then you line it up with the top perch. Get your jack ready to go up. Now you gotta make sure everything goes in. You notice the back end link didn't line up right. So you gotta pay attention to all the alignment on these guys. This is why you need two people to do this. You can do this by yourself, but it's not as easy, guys. So the first one you want to do is the primary one. And you can just leave it in there like that for right now, because that one won't go in all the way. That one has to be twisted into place. The next one will be the shock.
You want to go lower for that one.
Push up the shock. And then line it up. Go down, run over here. There you go. Get that to go in. I'm gonna push it in. There you go. You gotta wiggle the shock. Wiggle the shock, and then push in at the same time. There you go, see? And then the next one will be the end link. Same process, guys. Just remember, reverse everything. Once you have the bolts into place, we're gonna want to do this one next. Just put them in by hand. We're not gonna tighten them down yet.
All right.
Okay. So with your jack, you want to move the jack towards the edge of the control arm, so you can twist it up, so you can push in this bolt. See my finger right here? You're gonna have to wiggle it around until you get that going in, okay, guys? And with your, if you don't have anybody here, you can hit it in. If not, jack it up a little bit more. And you'll see it goes right in. That's it. And you can drop down the jack now. And that's your install for your rear spring. Thanks again, everybody, for watching. Like I said, this is a DIY for a
Mark 7 GTI
for new springs.